Hello, this video goes out to Mark. He asked me about making a mortar mix to hold the bricks together on his brick-built rocket stove. And so this is what I'm going to suggest. He has three items. He has a pile of potter's clay, a bag of quickcrete mortar, and a bag of perlite. So what I'm going to do is take the potter's clay and mix it up until it's soupy. I want it to be not wet like runny like water, but easily mixable with your fingers. Then I want to add an equal amount of the perlite to it, and that'll make it insulating in nature. And then I'm going to use that solution for the water to mix the mortar. Okay, so you've got a clay, water, and perlite mix that's soupy, and use that to mix the mortar mix. Now why? Well, the clay and the mortar together with the perlite will be a very, very light, not very heavy mixture. And between the several of them, they should handle the heat fairly well. The mortar mix is likely to handle up to about 2,000 degrees anyway. Not constant steady, but, you know, short time close to 2,000 degrees. The clay is going to make this a smoother consistency like pancake batter, which makes it real nice, especially when you're trying to get a really good seal on these bricks. And the other thing is, it looks to me like you don't want a lot of weight added to what you're building. So if we're not wanting to add a lot of weight, when the clay and the mortar mix and everything cure, they're not going to be nearly as heavy as they would be if it was just straight mortar. You might get 80 pounds of mortar in that thing by the time you're done. Another thing I might add is you're not going to need a 3/8 batch of this mortar in between each one of those bricks. I would put plenty enough on there to make sure that they seal well. So maybe 3/16 or 1/4 inch at max between these bricks ought to be plenty. The other thing that clay is going to do is it's going to kind of soak into the edges of those bricks a little bit and make sure that you get a really, really tight seal. And I think that's pretty important because we don't want this thing to allow noxious gases to come out. Then after I was done with that, I think I'd just plaster the outside of the stove when the inside mortar cures. And remember now, this doesn't cure by drying, it cures by carbon dioxide. So give it a week or give it several days for this stuff to set up pretty good before you start putting a fire to it. And then very, very slowly, because we've got to drive that moisture out of there or it'll crack. It'll crack. Anyway, that's the best I can say. You know, play with it a little bit until you get a nice a medium slump, high slump, where you can make a ball and hold it, and it won't just fall off. And I'm going to guess you're going to be probably 2/3 mortar mix or something like that to 1/3 of the other mix. But you know, that's just a guess. Just play with it until you get a good soupy mix with plenty of the mortar in there, so you've got lots of cement so that it will set up. Remember, this doesn't have to be horribly structural because you're not building a building. You're just holding these bricks in place and sealing them up. Anyway, that's my best advice on it. Remembering that we're making here a insulated concrete, a mortar, to hold these bricks together. Otherwise, there's a fellow out there that will say I'm making cement. Which, by the way, I have what I'm going to need, I believe, to make some refractory cement here in the next couple of days for everybody out there. Okay? Keep making it.